Hi folks, Peach Mario here with the third video of the Script Manager Bundle description. In the second video I showed you how to create or how to define the different footers for the scripts and the to-dos, and with this video we just will discuss a little bit, I will show you all the tillers and tell you a little bit what they are used for. So first of all we need a little bit more space in the sidebar, and then we start at the top. There is the grid to do template, which is actually used two times. So this is the to do editing element. It's used in the to do overview, and it's used in the scripts in the to-do section. If I create as a new tiller, then this is the same element which is used, the to-do template. Then there is the manager info, which just contains some information about the bundle. It also contains the information how to create the bundle. Yeah, we will have a closer look at this later. Then there is the link edit template. Yeah, so when we define links in the script, this is here, and this is the edit template is used to edit it. Then list all links creates the create a list container button that we know already, and then it defines this area and new and close area. Then there is list description template, which shows just the description. Then there is the new script button, which is this button here, which creates a new script. If I click it, then this is standard edit tiddler, nothing special, but the button is this one. Then there is the script footer macros, several macros, which we will discuss later. Then script list template is used in the list overview, script overviews. So this is this element. Script list template. Then there is the footer description, which we know already. The done element, the links element, and the to do, which contains different templates. So these are parts of the script footer. Then there is the color definition for the fold chevron here. So this is this one. Then there is the maximum height that we used in the configuration to define the code area, and this is the unfold color. The fold and the unfold color. I changed them, or I created a configuration element here, because the default settings is gray and I think it is not visible enough. So that's why I did create the settings for the control panel. And these are the elements that I used that hold the values. Then there is the styles, the style sheet definition, which creates the grids. This is also very new for me, and the styles will have their own video. Then there is the configurable styles, which use the values from those tillers that we showed already. So this one and this one. And this is one of the interesting things for TillWiki, that we can dynamically create CSS style sheets. Okay, the styles and the configurable styles element. Then there is the tags for the script footer, for the script. We know this already. The to-do footer and the to-do info, which is part of the to-dos, this element. To-do info. Yeah, the toggle me macro is very, very powerful element. It is basically used everywhere where we have these toggles, the close open toggle, yeah. Then in the to-do section, this close open toggle is created with the toggle me macro. Yeah, then there is the control panel, which is text control panel, so it shows up here in the control panel. Yeah. So we know this already, we have seen this already. Yeah, that's basically it. These are different components. Yeah, in the next video we will have a closer look at something else. I don't know yet. Okay, have fun.